Hello, my name is Trey Lutrick. I am the Director of Corporate Strategy for CenturyLink. This is a program that we're wanting to bring to you pre-recorded so that you can take an opportunity to hear the message that we're putting out in most of the public forums. And what we're really talking about is fiber to the home. A lot of municipalities have really come forward to us and said, hey, what does it take to bring fiber to my community? We see that a lot of economic development revenues are in jeopardy if we don't have this fiber to the home service. So what we did is we put together a process by which we looked at a lot of different cities in Orange Beach and the excellent telecom committee and working with the city council, the excellent relationship that we had, brought us together in an awareness campaign that we're driving to Orange Beach to accomplish this with a reverse attitude towards it. And what we're saying is that we're looking for 33% of the residents to really sign up on a pre-sales base before we actually put investments in the ground. This is important because what CenturyLink has done is that we've made extensive fiber investments around the country, and we try to spend our marketing dollars to sell people to buy onto those services. In order for us to make the investments into a city such as Orange Beach, what we really needed to do is know that there's pent-up demand there and exists today so that we could build to those customers, and because we're happy to do so. The key aspect of this program is that it takes the residents. The residents are the focal grassroots element to this. It's part of what we call the three-legged stool. We've got the provider, which is CenturyLink, that has a great fiber-based product that we're willing to bring forward. You've got a great municipality that really sees the value of that fiber service and wants to bring it forward to the residents. But it really takes that third leg, and being the residents need to help ensure that they do want the service and they want the fiber and they understand the value that it represents for them, and use that as a way to encourage participation amongst all of the residents there, because it takes you to sign up. Okay, so why fiber? Why is fiber the main topic element that we keep talking about? Well, if you'll look around, there's an ecosystem that's developing, and it starts with a lot of different things. Cloud computing is one of them. You've heard a lot about it. You may not know exactly what it is. But basically what it says is it's pushing more of the computational power and a lot of the storage aspects into the cloud so that you can minimize the amount of size and storage capabilities you keep on local devices. This is important, but bandwidth is really important to be able to leverage that cloud aspect. So as the demand for bandwidth keeps rising, it's by virtue of doing things with video, and you're seeing more 4K video, and you're seeing a lot of other elements to drive bandwidth. What we're really trying to do there with that bandwidth component is that we're trying to make sure everyone understands something. Bandwidth is growing. What you used as a 512K modem dial-up back in the day, now 1 gigabit services is the latest and greatest elevator speech relative to bandwidth. The Internet of Things are growing, and you'll see on this slide, there's a few icons that represent some, just a handful. There's thousands of them out there of different Internet of Things components that we're working with to drive value. The Amazon Echoes, the Wemo switches, Nest thermostats, all of these devices reside in a growing ecosystem that most homes are starting to be partake of. And that's just to say, as that ecosystem of bandwidth continues to grow, then these developers continue to produce and make new ones for that. So it's important that you've got the bandwidth in your homes to be able to leverage that. And also the other thing that we're trying to make sure that we think about with fiber is fiber drives value to your home. There's studies that show from the National Appraisal Association that having fiber to your home, because it's so coveted in so many different areas, can drive appraisal value increases from 1.5% to as much as 2.5%. And this is all based on where you are, so you'd have to research that element relative to where you are in that market. But the key thing to take from that message, it may not apply directly to your home, but it's something that's nationally being recognized, and so more and more communities are seeing that value with fiber, and they're wanting to try to figure out, how do I get fiber? So that's an important thing to take away from this. Okay. So then the next question we always get is, what about 1 gig? Why is 1 gig so exciting? Why is it such a demand? Well, because your usage today may not reflect a need for a 1 gig service. Over time, 1 gig will be the 512 of yesterday. This chart that you're looking at here really is indicative of computational power that you've seen. It's called Moore's Law. And what Moore's Law really does, it just represents on this trajectory. And I know this is a little bit of an eye strain chart, but what it says is, if you think about it this way, as the ecosystem develops the computational power over time, then the rest of the ecosystem embraces it to take advantage of that. When you take bandwidth, you take a lot of the different processes associated with what you can do with that kind of power, that ecosystem develops around it. And as such, all the other vendors and providers of services that support those, in this case, bandwidth for broadband internet services, needs to step up and be a part of that. So what you do today may not necessarily equate to where the future is tomorrow. So you're investing in a point of time where the labor and where we are with the installation of these services, so that we can at least get the infrastructure in place to support this ecosystem. All roads lead to fiber at this point. If you look at all the copper installation infrastructure elements today, whether it's twisted pair or coax, all roads lead to fiber to draw that bandwidth. We're pushing fiber closer and closer to your home, but the most coveted thing is having fiber in your home. And that's what we're talking about doing with Orange Beach today. Okay. The other thing that we talk about is a product called CenturyLink On that my team actually invented. I was the founder of it inside our organization. And what it really does is this. It says, I want to create a way to minimize the interaction both with customer service, not because we don't want you calling customer service. You can always pick up the phone and contact us. But what we wanted to do is make it more efficient and easier. We also want to minimize the amount of time it takes when you want to make changes to your service versus having a truck rolled out to your house and doing something. You still have the capability of doing that. We have technicians and customer service agents at your disposal whenever you need to. But CenturyLink On helps mitigate a lot of that for the large majority. What we say with that service is this. We create a Wi-Fi signal that when you attach to it, you can place your credit card information and your billing information, you prepay for your service, and you can manage this service on your own. So you might want to do 100 meg for the next 6 months, and then the latter part of the 6 months, you might do a gig. I tell an interesting story about an accountant that made a buying decision for his condo up in the Seattle market because of this particular service. Because what it did for him, it said, I can easily manage my account the way I want to do business without having to pick up the phone and contact someone and worry about how those changes are affecting my overall account with CenturyLink. So it gave him the flexibility that he was looking for. And the online support and self-service component, for those that are technically savvy, that want this type of interaction, it's important for them. Doesn't mean that you can't call a customer service, but this service right here has become monumental to the point where five of the top home builders in the country have said they wanted a part of their new services that are putting in our market. So we're seeing extreme success with it, and it's going really well. So I'm really excited about what this does and the fact that this is the first opportunity to bring it to a brownfield community like Orange Beach, where you guys can take advantage of this and be able to manage your service the way you want to. It's very important for the Orange Beach community. Okay, so let's talk about what we're doing for Orange Beach specifically. Let's get right down to the brass tacks. We're talking about a network build that's encompassing seven tranches right now, and our teams, if you want to use that word. What we've done is this chart represents where our current network facilities are, and we've divided these network teams into how we serve you today. Most of them have remotes or central office facilities in location, and they all tie back to that particular physical premise. So what we want to do is say, okay, if we're serving the community in this fashion, let's just divide this up in the same team structures. The population is fairly close. There's a little overage and underage on each one of them. The main thing that we want to tell you here is this, is that we don't typically identify and work with a city the size of Orange Beach. But what we've really said is this, if we can bring this idea to an Orange Beach, we need 1,000 customers to cover the core infrastructure, because there's a lot of things on gigabit servers and all the transport elements to come into an Orange Beach of its size that are typically identified with larger venues like a Kansas City or a Denver, Colorado. What this says is if we can get 1,000 people to sign up to cover the minimums on the core, then what we're able to do is now work with each one of these areas that if you can get 33% of the residents inside this team area to sign up, we will build it. And if the others don't, they don't get built. So we're hoping that the first time we get someone to sign up and start the construction, that by virtue of it will show the others the excitement and they will jump on that bandwagon with us. But let's be clear, what CenturyLink is doing here is part of a grassroots effort. These tranches that you're looking at on the screen, it's important that the residents inside each one of them, if you talk to 12 people that are friends of yours and those 12 people talk to 12 people, we can get the awareness out so that we can make a decision on whether or not we have true demand. If you're not excited about this service and it's not something you want to be a part of, completely understand. But the hardest thing that we have is not really getting a customer to a buying decision premise. It's really getting them aware of it, because we've had overwhelming excitement about the program, because who wouldn't want to have this? I mean, when all of the major municipalities are taking advantage of it and are clamoring for it and it's so coveted, it's something that I don't think that is a problem as far as gaining the acceptance. It's getting awareness, and so that's where you play into it. So each one of these tranches and teams are important for the residents inside it to really go after it. Okay. So the next part of this is what do you do with that awareness, and what do you do with the ideation of where we're going with this service? Okay, so what we're asking everyone to do is sign up by putting a $25 reservation fee out there to show your interest and support for what we're trying to do. I can't make it $0, because if I make it $0, everyone signs up, and we don't know really if you're interested or not. And I don't want to make it $100, because if I make it $100, then what ends up happening is somebody who might be on a fixed income, $100 might be important to them. So $25 is where we eventually got to, and we said we wanted to make that, it's a fair number. And what that $25 is going to do is, once you sign up, we're going to hold that $25 until one of two things have happened. If after 12 months we don't have enough acceptance for it, I'm going to give you that money back in the form of a refund. If, on the other hand, your team does hit its construction hurdle, then we will take that $25 and apply it to your first month's bill. And we'll be contacting you once everyone gains the excitement of where we're going with the construction and start it out, okay? Over time, what we're going to try to be doing, and we're making a lot of modifications on the fly, as we get more people signed up, we're going to be communicating to you where your team is, how many people have signed up. We're also going to be putting it out for the website for you to be able to go online and look at it yourself at your leisure whenever you'd like to. We're still working through a lot of that to make sure that we understand exactly some of the issues around the addresses and getting the numerator denominator of those particular areas kind of lined out. But I think we've got a good program lined up. Some of the multi-dwelling units along the beach are an example where you've got bulk units where they've already signed up either with us or another competitor to provide their services. We want to remove them from that denominator, because they actually would obscure the percentage of the people in those particular areas, because they're already obtained fiber services and we're doing something with them. So we're working through that as part of that initiative. But then make sure you understand something. At the end of all of this, your $25 will be refunded to you if we don't decide to go forward. So it's a show of support. The show of support is important, even if you are an existing CenturyLink customer. That's a key message. If you're an existing CenturyLink customer, you still need to go out and show your support. We will be contacting you because you're already a customer. We'll have mechanisms come in play and look for those. But if you want to go out and do this early, it has no impact on your existing billing structure. This is a completely separate initiative, but you